मेरे पास माँ है, वो भी दो।
डॉन के दुश्मन की सबसे बड़ी गलती ये है कि वो डॉन का दुश्मन है।
मेरे पास माँ है।
जो डर गया समझो मर गया।
मर गया।
जो डर गया समझो मर गया।
आल से कितने आदमी थे?
सलमान सर
स्वागत नहीं करोगे आप इनका?
क्या बात है!
My favorite dialogue, I've actually made a film. I love that film so much. Don ko pakadna mushkil nahi namumkin hai. Was my favorite dialogue. But I think to just paraphrase one line that they've used in a film, and that question came up earlier also. Lunch kab hai? Lunch kab hai? Lunch.
Lunch kab hai?
We have no choice because this angry young man, I think my father is the angrier one. So we still listen to whatever he says.
Ek ek ke baad ek sabko bulaya ja raha hai. Hamara koi zikr nahi hai. तो हमें कहीं भूल भूल तो नहीं गई क्या? हमें रिमाइंड कराओ भाई, हम भी हैं।
But the one that I think I watched the most that they worked on was a film called Kranti.
I just saw an interview of Mr. Manoj Kumar and he's taken away the credit from Salim Javed. He said that he's written it. They've lived their lives. तो इसमें negative भी बहुत आ गया उस वक्त. So they didn't care. Today we are made to feel that we should care where we should not actually. These two here, my father and Javed sir, they are men. They're still men because they want to be men. जब से कुछ समझ में आया तो सलीम जावेद ही समझ में आए, बाकी के कोई नहीं समझ में आया।
I'm sure you watched all of the movies so far, but is there something that was a discovery for you because you know you started making this series?
I think what I discovered making this series was that nobody really knew what happened. And after making this series, we've discovered we still don't know what happened with them. Nobody
that
knew.
Come in the next season.
Yeah, that's the next season.
Season two.
Yeah. So
that one is really controversial.
So yeah, somewhere you discover that no matter whatever happened, there was a respect intact. And yeah, that was like no one spoke beyond something. And I think that was something heartening.
Farhan, I hope a mic is magically near you. Thank you so much. I want to ask you how Salim Javed's work has inspired you as a writer and filmmaker, and then I'll ask you my next question.
You know, I think all of us who grew up in the 80s and were children of the product of films that were made in the 70s, we all carry the legacy of Salim Javed within us. It's not about just being a part of their family. It really is, as audiences, as viewers, the impact and influence of their film on all creative minds was just, it's undeniable. You know, so it has influenced my work. When I write scenes, I mean, it's not about emulating or copying consciously, but there is a certain darja, for the lack of another word, you know, that was given to the parts that they had written, and every character contributed in some way, had a personality, had a way of speaking, had a moment in the film, and I think that is subconsciously kind of come into the kind of writing that we do.
In fact, a more pointed
in all of us.
Absolutely. In fact, a more pointed question would be, is there a standout piece of advice that you perhaps might have received when you were undertaking your journey to be a filmmaker yourself?
A piece of advice that my dad gave me, he said, we come from a long tradition where sons never listen to their fathers. So please don't listen to me. Go ahead, go ahead and do whatever you want. So I tried my best to follow his advice.
We have no choice because this angry young man, I think my father is the angrier one. So we still listen to whatever he says.
And I'd love to ask you, the spark or the idea of creating this docuseries, when did it come about?
I think Zoya started this. Yeah. And Zoya and Farhan came to me, to all of us, and I thought that was the best thing that could ever happen.
Fantastic.
And I believe that they were the highest paid writers then. They're not leaving that position only. Even now. Look at this. Aur ye to acha hai, they didn't pursue acting. They didn't write for themselves. Ne to look at them. आजकल भी ऐसे दो हीरो नहीं मिलेंगे आपको।
क्या बात है, बिल्कुल, बिल्कुल।
है ना?
बहुत-बहुत शुक्रिया, रितेश। I hope mic is near you or it'll come to you. As someone who entered the film industry without any prior connections and has achieved so much success, how did Saleem Javed's legendary work and mentorship influence or shape your creative journey?
I mean, I think you're right. I had no exposure to films till I obviously, we did Dil Chahta Hai. But I think a lot of it came because from school, I remember Javed Uncle used to be at Holiday Inn working there. So you used to go there because our school was right across. And I used to hop across there with Farhan. And I would see some part of the process of what was the magic behind, right? So I think I got into it at that point. And then obviously you've grown up watching these movies in the 80s. And I think even today, like, and with Saleem Uncle, most of my interaction started after Dil Chahta Hai, because I remember after the movie release, Farhan and me for most of the films would go invite him. I obviously knew the family, Sohail, Arbaaz, Salman, all these people from C-Rock days. So, I mean, there was a lot which was there. So, I mean, I think there is a lot of influence in the work today because you've seen the stories they wrote, the way that the nuances of the screenplay, the characters, the emotional connect they had at that point, and it's even valid today. So, I mean, to be honest, even when I read a screenplay today, I try to find that connect and that emotion with which you can relate to and identify with.
Thank you so much for that answer.
And we in our industry are used to, we have to work under a lot of pressure. And he was already used to it.
He let him say it.
You only say. Because Marlik's pressure cooker belonged to him. So he'd already come from that background of working under pressure.
I must say, I have one of the finest co-hosts with me today, and that is Mr. Salman Khan. Thank you so much, sir. It's so lovely. Reema.
मैं फेंकी हुई पैसे उठा लेता हूँ. आजकल बहुत उठा रहा हूँ.
What do you think this is going to do to that partnership, Angry Young Men?
It's wonderful for us to partner with Prime, Amazon Prime, and you know it's going to drop in 240 countries. And to me personally, I mean, apart from it being a them being a huge contribution to the film industry, when I watch the docu-series, it's like two tigers who've done this beyond all odds. So there's a rags to riches story, there's a beyond all odds kind of story, and I think it's very universal, their journey.
Namrata, first of all, congratulations.
Thank
this
you
is
so much.
An outstanding moment.
Yes,
and it's amazing that this is your directorial debut. I'm going to straight up ask you about this creative journey from the start. I know we may not have time to go through all of it, but tell us something about the start of it.
Well, I mean, I've been an editor for 15 years now. And when Zoya asked me if I would love to do this, I mean, if I would want to do this, I was like, yes, because it just seemed like a great subject. And I mean, it was much more than what I thought. It was so amazing. It's been quite transformative for me. Yeah, it's been a great learning experience, and it feels surreal that it's happening, that everybody will get to see it. We have poured our hearts into it. We've worked on it for a long time, and I hope everybody can see it and enjoy it.
That's so wonderful. Congratulations again. Kaisa lag raha hai?
Acha lag raha hai.
बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया सलीम साहब.
नहीं ऐसा नहीं, नहीं चले जाए, आने वाली पिक्चर भी अच्छी होना चाहिए. इस पे काम नहीं चलेगा.
एक्चुअली हम लोग थोड़े इनसिक्योर हो गए थे पीछे बैठे, एक एक के बाद एक सबको बुलाया जा रहा है, हमारा कोई जिक्र नहीं है. तो हमें कहीं भूल भूल तो नहीं गई क्या? हमें रिमाइंड कराओ भाई, हम भी हैं.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल. आई डू वॉन्ट टू स्टार्ट बाई आस्किंग द बोथ ऑफ यू कि हम सब ने ये फिल्में देखी हैं, थैंक्स टू यू ये पूरा जनरेशन जो है वो आप ही की फिल्मों की बदौलत इस देश में हम बड़े हुए हैं. लेकिन व्हाट वाज दैट सीक्रेट फॉर्मूला आप हमें आज बता दीजिए दैट मेड सलीम जावेद सलीम जावेद?
फॉर्मूला ये है कि उससे बहुत से लोगों को बहुत तकलीफ होगी, इसलिए कि हम में तो थोड़ी बहुत अकल थी, बाकी बहुत बेवकूफ थे.
They don't make men like these anymore, let me tell you that. Javed sahab, aapse sawal puchna chahungi.
Ji.
What is it about your partnership that made it so special?
Ultimately the result, but you see, it was not planned, it was not organized, it was not on a very conscious level decided that we'll do that. It just happened. Incidentally, the first job I got in film industry was with Mr. Kamal Nuri for 50 rupees, then I jumped 200 rupees in Mr. S.M. Sagar's film, where I was an assistant director. Besides that, I was writing dialogue also because no other writer was willing to write the dialogue of Saradi Lutera. तो हम लोग झोपड़पट्टी में भी गए थे माहिम की सागर साहब के साथ, वहाँ एक राइटर था उसने भी रिफ्यूज़ कर दिया. फिर मुझे उन्होंने कहा अच्छा चलो तुम लिखो. तो मतलब चॉइस का मामला नहीं था, मगर वो मेरी ज़िंदगी की शायद सबसे अहम फिल्म है सरहद लुटेरा, बिकॉज दैट इज़ वेयर आई मेट सलीम साहब. सलीम साहब उस पिक्चर में रोमांटिक लीड कर रहे थे और मैं डायलॉग लिखता था और मुझे इतना परेशान करते थे वो डायरेक्टर साहब और प्रोड्यूसर साहब कि मैंने तय कर लिया था इसके बाद मैं नहीं लिखूँगा. मगर मुझे कॉन्स्टेंटली जो हिम्मत दी और अप्रिसिएशन दिया वो सलीम साहब ने कि आप अगर इस पिक्चर में ऐसे डायलॉग लिख सकते हैं तो आप सोचिए कोई ठीक पिक्चर होगी तो आप क्या करेंगे, आप राइटर बनिए. तो ये खैर बात ख़त्म हो गई. उसके बाद इत्तेफाक है कि मैं बांद्रा आ गया एक दोस्त के यहाँ और उसके साथ रहता, किराया वो देता था मैं रहता था. तो सलीम साहब का घर पास में था तो सलीम साहब के घर जाने लगा सारी मोहब्बत के साथ. एक ये था कि एक वक्त का खाना पक्का हो गया था तो फिर हम लोग बैठते थे कहानियाँ वानियाँ सोचते थे. एक दिन हम बैठे थे कि वही सागर साहब जिन्होंने सरहद लुटेरा बनाई थी, जिन्होंने हमें इंट्रोड्यूस कराया, वो आ गए और उन्होंने कहा भाई एक शॉर्ट स्टोरी है और तुम दोनों जो है वो उसका अगर स्क्रीन प्ले बना दो. तो हमने कहा ठीक है, कितने पैसे देंगे आप? तो उन्होंने कहा 5,000. तो आइए, मेरा तो एक हार्ट बीट मिस हो गया. तो हमने कहा ठीक है. तो हमने 14-15 दिन में वो स्क्रीन प्ले बना के उन्हें दे दिया. ये गोस्ट राइटिंग थी, हमारा नाम नहीं था पिक्चर में. लेकिन वहाँ एक सुधीर वाही थे जो अभी भी शायद आपके टच में हैं. तो सुधीर वाही जो है उसको तो मालूम था कि हमारा काम है. तो उसने कहा सिप्पी फिल्म चले जाओ. हमने सोचा सिप्पी फिल्म इतनी बड़ी हो हमें कहाँ काम दे. लेकिन एक दिन दोपहर में कुछ करने को नहीं था तो मैं चले ही गया. तो वहाँ बात की तो उन्होंने कहा अच्छा आप दोनों आ जाइए. मैंने कहा हम लोग तो साथ काम कर रहे थे, अभी ख़त्म किया हमने स्क्रिप्ट, तो आप दोनों आ जाइए. तो फिर हम दोनों गए और फिर हमें वहाँ काम मिल गया. तो वहाँ राजेश खन्ना से मुलाकात हो गई. राजेश खन्ना ने हमें कहा कि तुम हाथी मेरे साथ एक स्क्रीन प्ले लिख दो. तो कोई ऐसा दिन नहीं था, कोई ऐसा टाइम नहीं था जब हम दोनों ने बैठ के तय किया कि अब हमें पार्टनर हो जाना चाहिए. इट जस्ट ग्रू, इट हैपन लाइक दैट. और फिर तो आपको पता ही है, मुझे बताने की जरूरत नहीं है, रेस्ट इज हिस्ट्री.
सलीम साहब, इन्होंने इतनी सारी यादें हमें बता दी. अगर आपको भी उस दौर की कोई यादें हैं जो हमारे साथ इस वक्त शेयर करना चाहते हैं, बड़ा अच्छा लगेगा हमें.
क्या भाई
आपका माइक?
हेलो,
और पास.
हेलो,
आप ठीक?
हेलो,
आप ठीक?
हाँ ठीक है. हम जा रहे थे एक मरता हुआ एक फिल्म के उस पे प्रीमियर पे. हम जावेद सांबर में एक ही गाड़ी में थे जा रहे थे और हमारे सामने एक प्रोड्यूसर डायरेक्टर जा रहे थे जिन्होंने 20 साल पहले एक फिल्म बनाई थी. तो बच्चे आए और ठोकना शुरू कर दिया और बॉनेट को सलीम जावेद जिंदाबाद, सलीम जावेद जिंदाबाद. तो एक 10 रुपये का नोट निकाला मैंने और उनका कहा कि ये लो. और वो जाके आगे को जो उनका नाम दिया डायरेक्टर का कि उनकी गाड़ी के आगे क्या करो और उनका नाम दिया कि जिंदाबाद बोलो, जिंदाबाद बोलो. जो वो जैसे जैसे उसका जाके उसने जिंदाबाद बोलना शुरू किया तो उन्होंने पीछे मुड़ के देखा के देखा मेरे को जो लोग जानते हैं और इसकी बार गाड़ी चली. तो इंटरवल में जब सिगरेट पीने निकले तो हम लोग ढूंढ रहे थे कि हम कहाँ हैं. जो उसके बाद हम दिख गए उसे तो घुमा फिरा के जैसे आपने भी अभी थोड़ी देर पहले कहा देखा लोग जानते हैं और हर आदमी जानता है. तो थोड़ी देर बाद वो हमारे पास आके खड़े हो गए कि नहीं यार अल्लाह का शुक्र है कि 20 साल हो गए मेरी पिक्चर को मेरा बच्चा जानता है.
Zoya, this is a question for you. Tell us your earliest memories of watching Saleem Sahab and Javed Sahab at work.
My earliest memories are of the spaces, I think. Certain hotel rooms, the study in our house now, which for my luck, is my room right now. The study they worked in, I think it's the spaces, I think it's that A4 blank foolscap sheet and handwriting. That's my earliest memory of it.
Tell us that one film that you watched of the duo and what effect did it have on you? Any film, like a visceral memory that's never left you.
You know, I've watched all their work umpteen number of times. So be it Shole, be it Diwar, be it many films. But the one that I think I've watched the most that they worked on was a film called Kranti, which I watched, I don't know, maybe like 300 times. I saw that film. It was highly entertaining. I don't know if they will be happy that that was my first choice of Kranti. Kranti, Kranti. But no, all their work, all their work. I think, I mean, this documentary is aptly titled Angry Young Men because they brought their life experience, their voice, their identity into the character that we've all come to know as Vijay. And that's left like a lasting impression on all of us. But I mean, all of it, their work is absolutely spectacular. It speaks for itself.
No, I just saw an interview of Mr. Manoj Kumar, and he's taken away the credit from Salim Javed. He said that he's written it.
Did he?
Yeah.
Okay. So then we'll have a separate documentary for Manoj.
I think it's very, very honest him, honest of him that he has made this confession.
He says, "मैं लिखता था, मैं इनको सुनाता था, और ये फिर आके वही करके चले जाते थे." So but he did write it.
What is your favorite film of the two of them?
I've liked all their films. But for me, Deewar, Zanjeer, Dawn, Shole, ab kitne kitne naam le. Ke jab jab hum, like we produce a film, I'm sure even Farhan and Zoya must be revisiting all their films.
When did you realize that your father was no ordinary man, but the Salim Khan?
Kya sawal hai ye? Ab iska, is sawal ka jawab to kuch aur hi hoga. कि जब से कुछ समझ में आया तो सलीम जावेद ही समझ में आए, बाकी के कोई नहीं समझ में आया.
All of the women on the docu have said you were brats, you were brats, you were not humble and you knew your worth. Some of those women are sitting right here. Thank you for joining us today. It's so wonderful.
No, I must, in all honesty, accept that Salim Javed stepped on many people's feet. But to begin with, those feet should not have been there.
Of all the names, you went with Angry Young Men, which is, I think, the perfect name for this docuseries. But how did that come to you?
It was Zoya's idea. I mean, even when she had the idea first, she knew that it will be called Angry Young Men.
Oh, amazing.
Yeah, and we discussed it back in 2018. She already knew it's Angry Young Men.
Thank
and
you
I thought
so
it's a fab name.
Truly is.
Yeah,
thank
it,
you.
It epitomizes everything the docuseries is about. Yeah.
Thank you for that. Manish.
So this Brad thing is two people writing, giving hit after hit, hit after hit, hit after hit. And now they have to refuse a lot of producers, a lot of actors. तो वो वहाँ से आता है कि ये लोग अपने आप को समझते क्या, इनका दिमाग ख़राब हो गया है. दिमाग इनका नहीं ख़राब हो गया था, दिमाग इनका चल ही रहा था और बहुत अच्छे तरीके से चल रहा था क्योंकि ये हिट पे हिट दिए जा रहे थे और जिनके साथ ये काम नहीं कर पाए फॉर डेट्स और प्लॉट पसंद नहीं आया फॉर वट एवर, शक्ल पसंद नहीं आई, जो भी है कैरेक्टर पसंद नहीं आया, वो उन्होंने इनको टैग कर दिया कि इनका दिमाग ख़राब था, लेकिन एक्चुअली इनका नहीं था. जिन्होंने इनको ये बोला है वो उनका दिमाग खराब है. यू नो वन थिंग आई वर्क्ड विद अ लॉट ऑफ राइटर्स एंड सो हैज फरहान विद अ लॉट ऑफ राइटर्स, दे राइट. सलीम जावेद थॉट, दे पुट देयर लाइफ्स एक्सपीरियंसेस, व्हाट दे हैव लर्नड फ्रॉम पीपल अराउंड, व्हाट दे हैव सीन, व्हाट देयर पेरेंट्स हैव थॉट देम, व्हाट देयर चिल्ड्रन यू नो हैव यू नो द वे दे हैव ग्रोन अप, सो दे हैव टेकन फ्रॉम लाइफ एंड दे पुट इट ऑन सिनेमा. द रेस्ट ऑफ द राइटर्स सिनेमा से उठा के सिनेमा में डाला है. गॉड मेक्स मैन, दे डोंट वांट टू बी मैन एनी मोर, ही मेक्स अ लॉट ऑफ मैन, बट दिस जनरेशन दे डोंट वांट टू बी मैन. दीज टू हियर, माय फादर एंड जावेद साहब, दे आर मैन, दे आर स्टिल मैन बिकॉज दे वांट टू बी मैन.
व्हाट इज योर बिगेस्ट टेकअवे from this docu-series?
I think their grit, the fact that, you know, like Saman just said, what they were writing at that time, it was so reflective of what was happening in society. And also, I think writers were treated quite shabbily at that time. You know, in the industry, they had no status. And these two gentlemen came and just kind of broke all of that and just shattered, you know, the glass ceiling. And it's very inspiring. And I think it's inspiring to somebody who's not a filmmaker or a writer too, because it's your genuine rags to riches against all odds kind of story.
हमारे बच्चों ने सब बच्चों ने बड़ी अच्छी अच्छी बातें हमारे में कही, लेकिन सच ये है कि तो बहुत छोटे थे, नहीं क्या कितना याद है कितना नहीं, हम तो बड़े थे, हमें याद है ज़्यादा इन बच्चों के बारे में. मैं सलीम साहब से जब पहली बार मिला था तो सलमान वॉज नॉट इवन वन ईयर ओल्ड, 65, ही वॉज नॉट वन ईयर ओल्ड. और ये जो अभी इतने हैंडसम लग रहे हैं ये कोई अभी की बात नहीं है, बचपन से ही खूबसूरत थे. तो ही वॉज अ एक्सेप्शनली गुड लुकिंग चाइल्ड. और एक ब्लैक एंड वाइट तस्वीर आपके लिविंग रूम में हुआ करती थी, छोटी सी फ्रेम में, सलमान की पता नहीं अब है एक हो गई कहाँ है. फिर ये सब तो बाकी बच्चे तो मेरे सामने पैदा हुए हैं. अच्छा कमाल क्या है कि सलमान टुडे ही इज़ द ही मैन, ही इज़ द डैशिंग हीरो. ये इंतहाए शाय, बहुत ही कम बोलने वाला, बहुत चुपचाप रहने वाला बच्चा था. जो बदमाश बच्चा था वो वहाँ बैठा हुआ है. ये ही वॉज अ रेगुलर सेड्यूसर. सलीम साहब के घर में जो भी आता था कि ये तुम्हें पता नहीं है तुमने क्या क्या किया 6 बरस के बाद. ये जो भी इनका सलीम साहब का दोस्त होता था ये उससे एक स्पेशल रिलेशन बना लेते. ये बेचारा चुप बैठा रहता था और ये जो है उससे मिलके घुल मिलके लोगों को लगता था भाई बहुत कमाल का बच्चा है, है? और एक बहुत छुटपन में इसकी एक अजीब आदत थी, इसके बाल कभी बिखरे नहीं मिल सकते थे. ये कंघी करता था, एक 6 साल का बच्चा अपनी कंघी कर रहा है, ऐसा मैंने देखा नहीं कभी. तो सेल्फ लव इनका बहुत कमाल का था.
सेल्फ लव, आई लव इट. सो जेन ज़ी जावेद साहब, आई लव यू.
सब्सक्राइब करो गुजराती मिडडे, बेल आइकॉन पर क्लिक करीने मेळवो तमाम वीडियो ना डायरेक्ट नोटिफिकेशन.